When it's spring again, I'll bring again tulips from Amsterdam. With a heart that's true, I give to you tulips from Amsterdam. I can't wait until the day you fill these eager arms of mine. Like the windmill keeps on turning, that's how my heart keeps on yearning for the day I know we can hear these tulips from Amsterdam. I can't wait until the day you fill these eager arms of mine. Like the windmill keeps on turning, that's how my heart keeps on yearning for the day I know I can share these tulips from Amsterdam. I can't wait until the day you fill these eager arms of mine. Like the windmill keeps on turning, that's how my heart keeps on yearning for the day I know I can share these tulips from Amsterdam.
Wow. Thank you. I hope you enjoy that one.
Thank you, Matt, for that lovely, lively start to our programme this week. I hope you all sang along to Tulips from Amsterdam. And if you didn't, rewind, start again, and this time sing along. Hello, everyone. You're all very welcome. And you've got a special welcome from Trim's famous donkeys as well, who live near the castle in Trim and welcome all visitors during the summer months. We have the usual poetry, music and song today. Matt is going to sing another old favourite. We have a Robert Louis Stevenson poem. We have a look at the garden in autumn with music by Scéalta. And we have another number from Trim Musical Society's production of Oliver. But we'll continue as we started on the theme of bulbs. Here's a poem of mine on the subject. This poem of mine came about as a result of an interview I saw on Gardener's World on BBC a few years ago. It's called Bulbs. Bulbs. Death duties and the end of the slave trade have squeezed the profits of the big house. So each November they plant acres of tulips from the gate lodge to the Greek Revival portico and on down to the artificial lake with its island and early 20th century folly. Publicity in the right magazines ensures excitable trippers flock here, pay dues to spend windy spring afternoons ooing and awing at the squadrons of colour. Regiments of type browse the gift shop, relax over coffee and cake in the cafe. I remained determinedly unimpressed, but asked the keeper if there was a secret I might adapt to semi-detached suburbia. We buy new bulbs from Holland each year, he said. Allow these no second chance. One flowering, then dig them up, rejects. We share them out to local schools, nursing homes, community centres, hospitals, places that have to think twice about a flower purchase, scared it might be deemed an extravagant dereliction of the public monies, a front page scandal. Second-hand flower gardens, I thought. My favourite kind. Second-chance Edens, where colour, type and size are randomised, where no one is quite sure what will appear. When failure is expected, success a bonus, and no one has to pay for perfect planting.
Hello, everybody. I have an old friend called Tommy. Maybe I shouldn't say old friend. Or if I should use the word O, let's say it's in lowercase, old friend, called Tommy. And Tommy loves a song. I know he does. In the same way as some men love to whistle. Tommy loves a song. And he asked me, did I ever sing I'll Take You Home Again, Kathleen? He said, I'm a fan of your M&M series. Well, he must have missed one. Maybe he missed one because I did sing I'll Take You Home Again, Kathleen. But there are so many versions of this that I know that I wouldn't have sung a version that Tommy would like. Because songs get adopted and adapted by people, and this one is no exception. I'll Take You Home Again, Kathleen got favoured by people of different genres. So here is a version that I think Tommy would like. I'll take you home again, Kathleen, across the ocean wild and wide, to where your heart has ever been, since first you were my bunny bride. Whene'er you speak, and tears bedim your loving eyes, oh, I will take you back, Kathleen, to where your heart will feel no pain. And green, I will take you to your home again. I know you love me, Kathleen dear. Your heart was ever fond and true. Oh,
where your heart will feel no pain. And when the fields are fresh and green, I will take you to your home.
Tommy, I hope you enjoy that little rendition.
We'll be back after this short break.
Only you can make all this world seem right. Only you can make darkness bright. Only you and you alone can thrill me like you do. And
hi, more stuff from my diary. Saturday the 31st of July. Mary went to Navan today, not for anything in particular, but just because she could, which is a big step forward these days. Me, I was out only once today, and that was to collect our weekly takeaway, which we had after the rugby. It was a rotten game, a defeat for the Lions by South Africa. One game all. Sunday the 1st of August, the Taoiseach, Micheál Martin, has been saying that we are now ahead of our nearest neighbour, Britain, in the percentage of population vaccinated, which is pretty remarkable. Monday the 2nd of August, a bank holiday. Mary went out to Summerhill just for somewhere to go, and the big news out there is that Rosie has lost her first tooth. It happened while Mary was actually there. Great excitement. Lucy, who is 4 years older than Rosie, is the expert in this area and was able to advise Rosie on the protocol for the tooth fairy. Tuesday the 3rd of August, I rang Rosie for news about her tooth and got told the whole story. Wednesday the 4th of August, a lovely quiet day. I didn't go out all day. I watched the Olympics a fair bit, including a 13-year-old girl called Sky from GB who won the bronze medal in a skateboard competition. 13-year-old. We watched a movie this evening, Safe House. A thriller, very good, but too much shooting, Mary says. Thursday the 5th of August, got a call just after 9 a.m. and I'm still in bed. It's from my GP inquiring if my new tablet is going all right. If so, he will add it to my long-term prescription. Isn't that great service? Unheard of before this, and yes, it is going all right. Very well, in fact. Friday the 6th of August, I got my hair cut today with the barber, Daryl, a proud Yorkshire man. Is there any other kind of Yorkshire man? It's the first time I've been to the barber for about a year and a half because daughter Jane has been doing my hair during the pandemic and making a great job of it. Today I'm the only customer in the barber's. I experienced a blitz of calls today on my mobile. Calls from funny numbers, scam calls. Nothing new about that, says you, but that's true. But what was remarkable about today was the sheer number of these calls. 33 altogether. Starting just after 11:30 this morning, the last one at 2:55. Needless to say, I didn't answer any of them and none of the callers left a message. Jane was telling me a good one about Rosie, who is 4 and a half. Rosie wraps up parcels and leaves them outside the front door, then comes back in and a few minutes later goes out the door again and says, "Oh look, a parcel for me."
Here's a Robert Louis Stevenson poem from his collection A Child's Garden of Verses, published in 1885. Stevenson, as you know, was a well-known novelist, writing books like Kidnapped and Treasure Island. He suffered bad health all his life and went to Samoa in the South Seas for his health and died there in 1894. From a railway carriage. Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troops in a battle, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle, all of the sights of the hill and the plain fly as thick as driving rain, and ever again, in the wink of an eye, painted stations whistle by. Here is a child who clambers and scrambles all by himself and gathering brambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gazes, and here is the green for stringing the daisies. Here is a cart run away in the road, lumping along with man and load. And here is a mill, and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone. September as it fades into autumn, with music by the Irish, Swiss, German folk group Scéalta, in which Matt's son David plays a prominent part. Thank you, Scéalta, and thank you everyone who allows us to use their videos. We'll end with a video from a show by Trim Musical Society. It's another one from Oliver, and it's a fine life, if you don't mind having to like or lump it. We hope you enjoy all this, and we look forward to seeing you again next week. In the meantime, God bless.
Small pleasures, who would deny us these? Gin, toddies, large measures, no skimping if you please. I rough it, I love it, life is a game of chance. I never tire of it, leading this merry dance. Come on, you lot! If you don't mind having to go without things, it's a fine life.
It's a fine
life. Though it ain't all jolly or pleasure outings, it's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
When you've got someone to love, you forget your cares and strife. Let the prudes look down us, let the wide world frown us. It's a fine, fine life. Come on, Beth. Who cares if straight laces sneer at us in the street?
don't mind taking it like it turns out. It's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
And leave the candle burning until it burns out. It's a fine life.
It's a fine life.
Though you sometimes do come by the occasional black eye, you can always cover until he blacks the other one, but you don't dare cry. Go on, then. Such as me, mine's a fine, fine.